All right, motherfuckers. This video is a different type of video. You know, during Hater Mania, I've been making a video a day, and I've been enjoying it, don't get me wrong, but I mean, I feel sometimes like I'm running out of ideas, right? Because, you know, you can only keep up this charade for so long, right? There just isn't enough stuff to talk about in wrestling, you know? I can say this guy sucks, that guy sucks, all day and all night, and I will. You know what I'm saying? I will continue to do that. But once in a while, you come up with, not an idea, but with an anger inside you, right? That must be expressed. And I believe these are what make the good videos. So this is going to be an angry rant on possibly my least favorite wrestling personality of all time. Cucky Rhodes, all right? Enough of this guy. I mean, I don't even get tired of saying it anymore because this guy, every single week, every single time I see him, he does something else. He does something else. Right, to piss me off. He does something else to make himself worse and less interesting and more annoying, you know what I mean? First of all, let's start off with the fact that we all know, right? Number one, Cucky Rhodes is obviously someone that wants to be Triple H, right? If Triple H, like if we were 20 years ago, but with the culture of today, like if we had social media and all that shit 20 years ago, you know, when Triple H was like, maybe 21 years ago, when Triple H was like, just starting to get his like main event push, basically. At that time, right, Triple H would handle things probably the same way that Cucky is handling things, right? Except for the fact that Triple H is a grown man and I just don't really see him doing that. But that's a product of the time, right? If Triple H was around now and he was in the position that he was at 20 years ago, he'd be doing this shit. He'd be like hosting the All Out show with Brett Kirshner or whatever his name is, right? And all these other jabrons, you know? He'd be doing these things, he'd be having these little appearances here and there, right? He might even start his own company if he had that opportunity, right? However, Triple H didn't need to do that because he's going to get the company that there is to get, more or less. So, Cody Rhodes is basically a Triple H ripoff, right? This motherfucker, all he does is come out there and pretend to be other people. He has nothing going on for him himself, right? And every little iota of things that are distinctively Cody Rhodes things are not good. They're complete shit, right? So, first of all, the fact that he's still in the mid-card pisses me off, you know? I will give props where props are due, and that is this, right? He said he wasn't going to challenge for the title, and thus far, he's held to that. He has not challenged for the title. Now, I know that he'll find his way in there somehow, and he should, to be fair, right? He should, because he is one of, unfortunately, he is one of the biggest stars in AEW. But that's not because he's a big star. That's because when compared to people like Orange Cassidy and Jungle Boy, I mean, he looks like fucking Jericho, you know what I mean? And Jericho looks like The Rock. You know, and The Rock, in comparison, would look like Hulk Hogan. And Hulk Hogan would look like God. So there you go, motherfucks. Right? But the thing that annoys me the most about Cucky Rhodes is the shameless self-promotion that he, Kenny Omega, and the Young Bucks give themselves, right? First of all, is it a coincidence that when the company started, the Young Bucks and Kenny Omega and Cody Rhodes were all in the title pictures? Even Adam Page, right? They were all in the title pictures, right? All three of the singles guys were wrestling for the world title and the Young Cucks were wrestling for the tag title, right? And in order to give off this facade, this horse shit that they're doing, right? Pretending that like they're not in charge of everything, right? They booked themselves to lose in the beginning, right? Now, a lot of people, I think, may have been fooled by this. You know, they're like, oh, look at that. Like, Cody and the Young Bucks want to push young talent, you know? It's not all about them. And that was the exact point. That's why they did it. So people like me and people like Jay Rance and other people that talk about this couldn't immediately hold it against them. Because imagine what it would be like if the first pay-per-view of AEW was, I don't know, Kenny Omega versus Cucky Rhodes. Cuck versus Cuck match. You know what I'm saying? And the winner becomes the champion. And it didn't matter which one won. Let's say Cucky Rhodes won that match, right? Everyone would be like, oh, what the fuck? What is this? Like, you're just making a company to make yourself the champion? No. Instead, they elected to give it to people that were, like, whatever, industry veterans, right? Jericho got the world title, which made sense because he's the only name that anyone recognizes when they tune into that show. And then the tag team titles were given to the throwaway team of Frankie Kazarian and Scorpio Sky. No one cares. You know what I'm saying? No one cares about these guys. These guys aren't even a real team, right? The real team was Frankie Kazarian and fucking Daniels, but it is what it is, you know? But they gave it to them only so they wouldn't give it to themselves, right? And then they played, I don't want to say hot potato because, like, not a lot of title changes happen, right? But eventually they gave it to Jon Moxley. Jon Moxley is another guy, right, who is an established guy. Like, after Jericho, he's the second most known name. right? He's actually a guy that was champion in WWE. Did he have a shitty title run? Yes, but he was champion nonetheless. So this, once again, got the heat away from Cucky Rhodes, Cucky Omega, and the Young Cucks, all right? It got the heat away from them, you know? Eventually, the tag titles were switched around here and there. I don't even remember who the tag team champions were. I know eventually FTR won them, but I mean, prior to that, Cucky Omega and Adam Page won them, so that was probably the beginning of the turn, of them pushing themselves, right? And then eventually, motherfuckers, eventually, look where we are, right? The Young Cucks and Cucky Omega have the pretty much all the belts that matter. And Cucky Rhodes is probably going to win the mid-card belt once again, right? So somehow, Cucky Rhodes has managed to, like, put the belts exactly where he wants them to be. You know what I mean? Like, there's no doubt about it, right? The Young Bucks will go down already. They will go down as the best tag team in the history of AW. Even if AW lasts 100 years, no one is going to beat the reigns that the Young Bucks are going to have. There is no chance in hell of that happening. You understand me? You know, that's the kind of the problem here. Cucky Rhodes, same thing, you know? All he's doing is prolonging the inevitable. He understands delayed gratification, right? He just keeps being a jobber for a while, tries to quote-unquote put people over. I don't think Cucky Rhodes is capable of putting anyone over because he's not over, you know? But anyways, he's going to try to put people over here and there, and then eventually they're going to have this master storyline, maybe in a year or two, where Cucky Rhodes finally fulfills the prophecy and wins the AEW title, and he will dedicate this to his father, you know what I mean? And I think they're also hoping that by that time, the company grows a bit, right? So, like, now they have Sting and a bunch of other people, so maybe the company grows a little more, and it actually means something, you know what I mean? The AEW title actually means something. But think about that. Think about everything I just said, right? Think about this shameless self-promotion, you know? Anybody that is an AEW fan that hated when Triple H was champion forever or hated when John Cena was champion forever must remain consistent and must hate this garbage too, right? Do you really think, like AEW is shit now because there's nothing to watch. You know what I mean? Like they have a match, Santana and the other guy, Ortiz, whatever. Ortiz, there you go. Santana and Ortiz versus fucking the Young Cucks, right? And it's for the titles, and it's like, you know, everybody knows that Santana and Ortiz are not going to win the titles in a throwaway pay-per-view this close to the Young Bucks winning the titles. It's just not going to happen. Same thing with Cucky Omega, you know, like the next three pay-per-views, like I don't give a shit. It's going to be him versus Moxley in like a whatever deathmatch type situation at the pay-per-view. I don't want to see it. I mean, I want to see it for other reasons, like I want to see what deathmatch stuff they're going to do, but I don't want to see the match because I already know the outcome. The outcome is going to be this. John Moxley's going to get screwed out of the title. 100%. We all know this. You know what I mean? Nobody can surprise me with this. But back in the day, at least, when Triple H was champion, you know, you kind of knew that Triple H was going to go to WrestleMania as the champion, right? Back in WrestleMania 2000. But Mick Foley gave him a hell of a fight, and there was always a possibility. There was always a chance that Mick Foley wins the title. You know what I mean? And ultimately, Mick Foley ended up being on in the WrestleMania match too. So who the fuck cares? The point I'm trying to make is that, like, at least back then, when people were politicking their way into matches and into main events, it was good. The matches were good and the storylines were good. Now they're not. And who do I blame for this? Cucky Rhodes. Because why the hell would Cucky Rhodes, right? Why would he actually try hard and become interesting, you know? Why would he try to be good when instead he can just start his own company? I mean, good for him. The success that AEW has had should not be understated. I mean, I think it's a shit company personally, but it has been successful in many ways, you know? I think, like, the main point of success, though, comes from the fact that Tony Khan is just not very smart. That's the only explanation. He's like a nerd, right? And he thinks that Kenny Omega and Cody Rhodes are cool kids, and he's like, oh, the cool kids want to be friends with me. That's the only explanation, because all they're doing is taking his money to promote themselves. You know what I'm saying? What is Tony Khan getting out of this? There's no way the company's profitable yet. Absolutely no way. Even without COVID, they probably wouldn't be profitable. Because, and here's the thing, motherfuckers. A lot of people don't get this. People think that it's like you start a wrestling company and then the ticket sales come in and that's all money in your pocket. No, motherfuckers. Do you understand the amount of startup costs that are required to start a TV show and then the startup costs that are required to start a wrestling company? It is like tens of millions of dollars, probably more, maybe even like $100 million to do something at this scale, because you have to pay these jabrons, right? Cucky Rhodes and these people are probably getting paid millions. You know what I mean? You have to pay yourself, right? Tony Khan's going to want a salary out of this. You're going to want to do things like trademarking and branding, right? And that's going to cost a lot of money to just promote yourself, right? The ads are going to cost a lot of money. You know, TV time is going to cost a lot of money, right? That deal that they have with TNT, You think TNT is doing that for free, motherfuckers? No, TNT is getting paid from it. And not just the ad revenue. They're probably getting some sort of upfront cost, right? So the amount of money that Tony Khan and his, more importantly, his father, who's the actual businessman, have spent is probably insane, right? There's no way that AEW has recouped that money. This is a long-term play. Like, the only way that AEW becomes profitable is through, like, many, many years of sustained growth. And I don't think they're having that right now. Again, you have to blame COVID, but it is what it is. The point is, people like the Young Cucks and Cucky Rhodes are pretending this company is successful, and they're doing so with the wallet of someone else, right? There's nothing I hate more. There's nothing I hate more than people that use other people's money to pretend to have achieved something. You know what I mean? There's nothing wrong with getting a little help here and there. Absolutely not. Sometimes your parents may need to help you with like some expenses, let's say, especially when you're young, you know? Nothing wrong with that. But what's wrong with it is then using that and being like, look how successful I am. You know what I mean? No, motherfuckers. No. Use that correctly, right? And Cucky Rhodes is not using it correctly. Because if he were using it correctly, he wouldn't spend so much time self-promoting himself and to a lesser extent the Young Cucks and Cucky Omega. Now, here is where the real difference comes, motherfuckers. Here is where the real difference comes. You know, this video is why I hate Cody Rhodes. And while I also dislike the Young Cucks and Cucky Omega, they're not part of the title of this video for a reason. And that reason is that they are less detestable than Cucky Rhodes. And here's why. This is the most important part of the video, in my opinion. Cucky Rhodes, right, is not part of their little group. Let's be honest, right? Cucky Omega and the Young Cucks, they're out there in Japan, and they became friends in the 2 years or whatever they worked together, right? And in those 2 years, they pretty much ruined the Bullet Club and made their own little faction out of it, you know? Which was really stupid, in my opinion. I believe Bullet Club has yet to, like, you know, recover from this. But nonetheless, here we are, right? They had that stupid-ass, like, all Bullet Club, like, firing squad. Like, this stupid shit. Tama Tonga shouldn't be a leader of anything, you know what I'm saying? This guy's, he has tag team wrestler written all over him, you know what I mean? This guy is, like, he's like Gallows. You know what I'm saying? He's like Luke Gallows. Like, that's his capacity. Luke Gallows is not going to be the leader of the Bullet Club. And neither should Tama Tonga. The point being, motherfucks, that these people, Cucky Omega and the Young Cucks, the Elite, right? They had their own thing in Japan. And they have leveraged that thing as they have to create this company. What they bring to the table is exactly that. What Cucky Rhodes brings to the table is basically nothing other than the fact that he's the son of Dusty Rhodes. That's literally all he brings. You know, because Cody Rhodes is not this exceptional wrestler. Cody Rhodes is not this exceptional wrestling mind, right? He's none of these things, right? It's like if they had done it without him and instead gotten Marty Scurll, same shit would have happened. Only difference is Marty Scurll's dad isn't Dusty Rhodes, so you can't prostitute his name like WWE does, for example, right? You can't just use his name to just sell tickets, right? And Cucky Rhodes, I mean, if anyone has a right to do it, it's Cucky Rhodes, because he is his son. But he shouldn't lean on it so much. But nonetheless, the point I'm trying to make here is this, right? The Elite, they come to AEW, and now their push is starting, right? Like, they're the champions. Cucky Omega is the world champion, and the Young Cucks are the tag team champions. But their storyline is about the Elite, right? It's about the Elite and about Bullet Club. That's why they have Gallows and Anderson there, you know, and the Don Callis. Like, they have their own storyline, you know? Cucky Rhodes doesn't have any storylines. Cucky Rhodes has basically never had a storyline in AEW. The only storyline he had was the one with Jericho. And even that wasn't really a storyline. That storyline was like, yo, I'm going to win. Jericho's like, no, you're not. That was the entire storyline, right? There's no actual plot development, right? Cucky Rhodes is exactly everything that all the smarks hate, but they refuse to see it this way, right? He is literally John Cena. There is no difference between him and John Cena in the way that they're presented, right? They're presented as these two guys who are like all American, right? They're supposed to be good-looking guys that win matches, you know? That's all Cody Rhodes is. He's just a guy that wins matches, you know? He hasn't had anything meaningful in his career. Like, he's had matches where the other guy has had a gimmick or a storyline, right? He had matches with Brody Lee. He had matches with Brian Cage and all the other shit. I think so. I'm not sure, to be honest, right? He had all these matches, but they didn't really mean anything, right? It's just like him having a match with someone else. You know, he even stole the John Cena, like, you know, mid-card champion, like, open challenge thing. Remember when John Cena did that? When John Cena was a U.S. champ and he would have the John Cena's open challenge? Right? That's exactly what Cucky Rhodes started doing. That's why we got treated to things like Warhorse, motherfuckers. Things we never thought we'd see. Yep. So there you have it, right? But unlike John Cena, obviously he lacks the star power, he lacks the muscles, and he lacks the abilities, let's be real, right? But more important than that, right? John Cena does not shamelessly, because it's not his company, does not shamelessly promote himself and his horseshit, right? Cucky Rhodes, this is the reason that I hate him the most. This is the reason why I really dislike this guy, right? Because he is using someone else's hard-earned money, right? The Khan family's hard-earned money, to do shit like promote the gender of his child. You know what I'm saying? What the fuck was that all about, right? This is what really influenced me to make this video, right? I don't give a fuck what gender his child is. You know, the amount of arrogance that is required for someone like Brandy, right? And Cucky Rhodes as well. But I feel like this is more of a Brandy thing, right? Like the amount of like arrogance that Brandy and Cucky Rhodes have to have a little ceremony of a gender like reveal party, right? Is ridiculous, motherfuckers. It's ridiculous. They really think they're like A-list celebrities. Nobody gives a fuck. I had forgotten that Brandy was pregnant, you know what I mean? And maybe that's the strategy. The strategy is just remind us every week that Brandy's pregnant, right? Because otherwise no one would care. And no one should care. You know, good for them. I'm happy they're having a kid. Good for them. But I don't give a fuck. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is not part of of wrestling. I don't tune in to get updates on Brandy's pregnancy. I don't care. I hope it goes well, but I don't give a shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, if they had a show called Brandy's Pregnancy, no one would watch. And they know this, right? But despite this, they take advantage of their position and they promote themselves shamelessly, right? Triple H and Stephanie never did this. You know, they did other things. Like, they promoted themselves, but it was always ironic. It was always tongue-in-cheek. So, for example, when the Authority was the bad guy on Raw, right? Triple H and Stephanie would, like, make out, and they would kiss, and they would be affectionate in the ring. But it was presented exactly as it was, right? It's supposed to be these two rich, arrogant assholes that are kissing. They were like two Marie Antoinettes. You know, they were like, oh, let them have cake, right? It's the same shit. You know, but Cucky Rhodes and Brandy are faces, and they're not presented in the same manner, right? They're affectionate and loving because they're in love, motherfucks, you know, which is good for them. But I don't need to see that. It has no point, no place in the storyline. It brings nothing to the table. And more importantly, their kid already doesn't deserve this, you know? Poor kid. Before he's born or she's born, I guess, right? They're already being paraded around as a prop. You know, I don't like it myself. And that's up to them, but the facts are what the facts are, you know? Cody Rhodes wants so badly to be culturally relevant. He wants so badly, like, to be a household name. That's why he's, like, a judge on the Go Home show, and no one cares about that. That's why he's a wrestler in AEW, and no one cares about that, right? And more importantly, that's why he wants to somehow brand himself. He keeps branding himself, you know? He got a tattoo of his own logo. How goofy is that, honestly, right? He got a tattoo of his own logo, and now the last straw. He and Brandy are wasting good money, right, to promote their child and the gender of the child. This is ridiculous. For those of you that didn't see, last week on AW Dynamite, motherfucks, right, Brandy Rhodes comes out and says, like on a little promo, a little vignette, she's like, you know, nobody knows the gender except for me. And we're going to reveal it. I was going to do it with friends and family, but I thought, why not do it live today? Gee, I don't know, stupid. Maybe not live today because no one gives a fuck. You know, you have to know your audience, man. You have to know your audience. Now, maybe these neckbeards do give a fuck. I don't know. I'm sure in 5 years, they'll be like, oh, the most beautiful baby of all time. Like, fucking weird shit, you know? But the rest of us don't give a shit. I don't tune in to learn about baby genders when I watch wrestling, motherfuckers. And no one does. You know, the facts are what the facts are. She wasted company money to film that little promo, right? Now you're probably thinking, well, how much money is that? Doesn't matter, motherfuckers, even if it's 20 cents. What end does it serve? What end does this serve? You know what I'm saying? So like, boom, there goes that right there, right? All that money, gone, right? Then they waste the money on the pyro, for the pyro to be pink, and on the Titantron. And then more importantly, they waste the resource of time, motherfuckers. They waste the resource of time. The 3 minutes that were given to Brandy talking about the gender of her child could have been given to literally anything else. You know what I'm saying? And it would have been more productive for the company. And that is the final straw. All these motherfuckers, Cucky Rhodes himself included, right? All these little bitches that come out on WWE right after they get fired and they say things like, the company didn't use me correctly. You know, the company didn't push me enough. I didn't get enough TV time. Cucky Rhodes complaining about TV time is the biggest hypocrisy of all time. Because you are taking TV time away from anybody. It doesn't fucking matter who it is. It could have been Serpentico. I don't give a shit. Why isn't Billy Gunn and his son on TV? Why aren't they on TV? You know what I mean? You could have given anyone 20 seconds or a minute to cut a little promo, right? That's all you need sometimes to put yourself out there and get people talking. You know? Look at Zack Ryder. That's how he did it. You know? You could give people 30 seconds, a minute, 2 minutes, instead of using this time to talk about the gender of your baby. Can you imagine this? Can you imagine this horseshit? If Vince McMahon did this, people would be like, I can't believe that Cesaro isn't getting those 3 minutes, but Vince is talking about the gender of his baby. You know what I mean? That's what everyone would say, but nobody fucking says it for AEW for some reason. You know, it's as if Cody Rhodes can do whatever the fuck he wants. You know, like the rules don't apply to him anymore, right? I read this thing today about a girl that was bullied, right? And she said that eventually she transferred schools, and then in the third school that she transferred to, the kids were like handicapped or something, so she would bully them, right? And she thought to herself, I am the strong one now, right? Exactly. That's exactly what Cody Rhodes is doing. When he was down on the card and he was begging for that minute and a half, and people were like, nah, sorry, Cody, we can't give it to you because you're Stardust. We're going to give it to Neville instead, let's say, right? Yeah? Which is a reasonable thing. We're going to give it to Neville, not you, because Neville's better than you, so we're going to give it to Neville, right? And he's like, oh, they don't give me my time. I deserve better. Now that he's the strong one, now that he's in charge of the time, right? He's like, no. Sorry, everyone on AEW Dark. Sorry, half the roster that doesn't get it featured on TV. My baby's gender reveal is going to take up 3 minutes, 3 minutes of TV time. My baby's gender reveal is more important than your career, is what he's saying to these people. Now, again, no harm done. Honestly, like if this is all he did, and he did it once, I understand. You know, you're the boss. You're excited that, like, you know, you're gonna have a kid. You're excited your kid's gonna be a girl. Cool. No worries, motherfuckers. No one's gonna hold this against him forever. I'm just saying, considering what he is and what brand he is, right? Basically fake Triple H and fake Stephanie McMahon, right? Nepotism galore, right? Considering all this shit, he has the nerve to do this after complaining about how he was mistreated in WWE and Brandy, same thing. You know what I mean? Like, are you kidding me? Does no one see the irony in this? Does no one see the hypocrisy in this? Cucky Rhodes is a piece of shit for doing this. You know, everyone out there, right? And it's also one of those things where it's like, no one can say like, hey man, what the fuck? Because at the end of the day, we're talking about a baby, right? No one's going to be like, hey, come on, dude. Like, I need time. Like, fuck your baby, you know? No one's going to say that to him. So it's one of those like no consequence, built-in excuse moves. You know, that's all he did. He took advantage. He has taken advantage of the fact that he is, number one, Dusty Rhodes' son. But more importantly, he has taken advantage of the fact that, number two, he is now the boss, right? I don't give a fuck. Tony Khan is either a pussy, a cuck, or extremely stupid. Possibly all three, motherfuckers. Possibly all three. Because if one of my employees came to me and said, excuse me, in your 2 hours of TV time, I'm gonna need 3 minutes to talk about the gender reveal of my baby, I'd be like, shut the fuck up, go on AEW Dark and wrestle Serpentico. Job to him, and then we'll talk, motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Who the fuck do you think you are telling me what to do? You know what I'm saying? That's the kind of shit, that's the kind of attitude that Tony Khan needs to have. But Tony Khan doesn't have that attitude. He doesn't have that image. He doesn't have that respect, right? He's just a guy that's told, we're gonna do this now, cuck. Deal with it, you know? Like, people, like I don't know, maybe he's just very stupid. Maybe he's not a pansy at all. And he's just so stupid that he's just easy to confuse, easy to manipulate. Maybe they tell him, like, hey, you know, the fans really do care about the gender of Brandy's baby. And he's like, oh, do they? Yeah. Like, maybe he's one of those retards. I don't know what to tell you. All I know is this. This guy is not making the right moves here, right? He's not making the right moves for his show. And also, you know, he has a duty as the owner and the boss, right, to check people like Cody Rhodes. He has a duty to be like, wait, Cody, the thing that you're suggesting we do is inconsistent with the complaints you had before you started this company, right? This company was started as an alternative to WWE. And one of the things that people don't really talk about, but one of the things that people hate about WWE is exactly that. It's the shameless self-promotion that WWE engages in, right? The shameless self-promotion of, like, storylines that involve, like, the family, right? That was one of the big complaints back in the day. Oh, the McMahon-Helmsley era, right? Even afterwards, like, how many McMahons do we need to see, like, on TV, right? You know, when they had, like, the Battle of the McMahons at WrestleMania 2000, that was a big complaint, you know? Shameless self-promotion. And that actually had a purpose. But it is what it is, motherfucks. All I'm saying is exactly that. I'm saying, motherfucks, right, that WWE did a great job dealing with people like Cucky Rhodes. And the reality is this. Cucky Rhodes and, honestly, the rest of the elite are not much better. They're not better than Vince McMahon. They're not these, like, you know, wrestling purists They're not these like Robin Hoods that they like pretend to be. They're the same shit. When given the opportunity, they too promote themselves and virtually only themselves. Ask yourself, motherfuck, how many number one contenders have there been, right? Except for Eddie Kingston, which stands as a complete outlier, and in my opinion, a mistake to have been made a WWE contender. Sorry, a number one contender for the AEW title, right? How many people in that company have ever been in a main event? How many people? It's been like 5 or 6 people, and all of them, like I think, I'm pretty sure all of them, except for, what's his face? Eddie Kingston, all of them, and MJF. He was in the main event, I think, once, right? But all these guys, I'm talking about pay-per-views here, all these guys are WWE superstars. All of them, right? AEW has not pushed one guy of their own, you know? The only exception is maybe Darby Allin, but he's the mid-card champion. No one really cares about that, you know? The facts are what the facts are. They're not doing anything different from WWE. Not one thing. You know what I mean? All they're doing is taking WWE guys and treating them better than they were treated in WWE in some cases, and worse in other cases, right? Until I see the main event being like MJF versus Orange Cassidy versus Darby Allin for the world title in a triple threat, then AEW is just a WWE knockoff. They're just WWE velocity packaged in a different way. That's all it is, motherfuckers. It's WWE UK, basically. Think about it, motherfuckers. That's all I gotta say about that. Cucky Rhodes, this guy is really fucking things up, and this was the last straw, in my opinion. I cannot believe that he's being allowed to do this by people like Tony Khan. I cannot believe it. And with that being said, motherfucks, I'll talk to you later up in this bitch. Motherfuckers!